Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky back here in the laboratory. I am testing the TrueFire green on my spoons. That's what the spoons were for. As you can see here, I've got all of my templates laid out, okay, and I've started to use some of them. And you'll see, I mean, again, I don't, you know, I'm just doing this from having watched some of the DVDs that Mike Levalay and a few other people have released. And so, you know, it's not an exact science, and you're always going to get kind of different results until you once again warm up and you start getting better at it. I taped down the spoon so that they wouldn't move, and, you know, you begin to see some of it. And again, it's just a matter of adding a few layers, pushing it back with the organic green candy, and then just bringing out some of the highlights with these things, you know. And you'll see. I'm going to walk you quickly through the process, except I'm describing it now, and I'll describe it in the next part of this video. But it's going to be voiceover because I'm going to be wearing my mask. I'm shooting House of Color. And so I'm protecting myself, and, you know, I got my gloves on and all of that good stuff. But anyway, you start, you know, you use these things to sort of pick out licks along the way. And as I said, there is no, you know, you're just going to get different results. And I'll walk you through it on this spoon. And that's it. And hopefully it won't be too long of a video. But anyway, I've got my supplies ready. The yellow, the chrome yellow. And, you know, for right now, this is all I'm going to be using for this stage. It's chrome yellow and then organic green candy, okay? Base coat, I'll leave them here, although they're already loaded in the airbrushes. And so the next step is I'm going to pause, set up, and then there'll be a voiceover, all right? So stay tuned in for airbrushing. It's airbrushing time. All right. All right, I got the chrome yellow and the airbrush, and we're good to go. So make sure you hold down your body part. And, you know, one of the first step here is I usually fog paint right along the edge where the fire would have started. And then I freehand some loose licks here and there. You know, this doesn't have to be accurate at all because it's going to all go in the background. You're going to push this back with the organic green candy, but you want to define it as much as is humanly possible at this point. But you know, I this is just my little thing. I do the fogging and then these licks, and you know, you give them shape this way. And you make sure that I'm trying to set the camera angle so you get a better view here. And here we go. Hopefully my hands won't get in the way. Constantly clean your tip needle. I find that when I'm using chrome yellow and then white, the paint tends to dry a lot faster on the tip. So clean the tip. The airbrush this morning has been spitting a little bit of moisture, so I've stopped a couple of times to correct it. And see, you could see them there, the bubbles, and then you just blow them away. That's the beauty of working with House of Color. You can, you know, you can really bounce back from a mistake that would be devastating using some other paint system. I've already started using the templates there. And again, no exact science. You just have to sort of look for and create the shape of the lick. This spoon actually turned out pretty well. And you know, this you just practice and you practice until you feel confident that you are going to be able to carry the process over to your model and not ruin it. But if you ruin it, then you know where it goes, back to the purple pond. These are the Mike Levele True Fire mini templates that are absolutely, I think these are called nano templates. You could pick them up at Coast Airbrush, where I pick up all of my supplies. The link is posted on the masthead of the channel there. There you see a little bit more water spitting. So anyway, the beauty of doing this with a double action is that you could actually press and just with the air blow those suckers away, you know. It's a very tedious, very slow process, but it's—I have to say—it's quite a bit of fun. And notice I don't do it on every vehicle, just because it really gets to me. It's very intense, very intense, but at the same time very rewarding. So, if I remember Mike's best advice, which was, you know, loose to tight, which means, you know, begin loose and then work towards tightening the licks and making sure that you give them definition. That's what it's all about. But the danger, of course, is that they'll end up, you know, you end up repeating the same pattern over and over, and then it looks like you have these, you know, those old beer holders that were made out of plastic, you know, a six pack. You'd remove that stuff and you'd have six holes the same, looking the same. So you want to change your templates, you want to change the shape and size and movement, direction, movement of your licks. That's why you see me moving around. And I've seen a lot of people who do this really well. I'm not convinced I do this as well as some others, but that's, you know, this is not a competition. This is just about doing certain things to your models and being pleased by it. Everybody has a learning curve. Everybody has skills they develop over time. One of my favorite airbrush artists is, of course, Craig Frazier. I just love his work, and I love his attitude and his approach to airbrushing. So here we have a little bit more work. This is all the work that you do before pushing this back into the background with the organic green candy. And with the green and blue fire, you don't have as many levels or steps to do, so you want to get it right in the first couple of times, because you're just working with yellow and green, and that's all you're doing if you think about it. See, there I go freehanding again a little bit, and you begin to see this taking shape. Again, the eye will pick it up when you look at the finished product. The fire in the background, kind of loose, and then the fire in the foreground, really tight once you apply the candies. And the two candies here are organic green, and then a mixture of lime gold and organic green, 50-50, so that you get this kind of an antifreeze. That's what Mike Levele calls it, antifreeze green. And then you just hit the brightest spots with a little bit of the lime gold by itself. And there's a little bit of bling that goes on at the very end, but we'll get it. We'll talk about it when we get there. So that's pretty much it, you know. There we go. Hopefully the camera picks it up. So that's the first step. That's basically it, and then I'm going to push that into the background. You see the other spoon over to the right. That already has the organic green. That's why I put it there so you could see it. So you kind of push this intense yellow back into the background with the organic green.